trash. You know, it's like, who gives a shit about the kids? They get the money because they're taking care of their kids. But there's no definition of taking care is beating or not even caring if they die or live. But also, it could be used for parents who are like, yeah, I'm a single parent. Yeah. I mean, look, I'm divorced. Technically, right? And then they get the money and then they're like with their husbands. Or with their boyfriends, girlfriends. And it's kind of like, you aren't single. I mean, you aren't living. It's just not just your paycheck that's going to the household. It's somebody else's. Probably if you add that up, it's not really. It's probably way more than you could, than is allowed. And I get welfare is not enough, not a lot. Although welfare is supposed to be just for you to help you get a job. Most people just live on it. I don't really mind living on stuff. Well, except for the government that we have to pay. Like, I don't really mind if you, like, own a business and, you know, if you, like, your mom owns a business, like me, and you're just, like, living off it. Although I am trying to do less plays to get a business. Or at least to make money. So I can contribute. Not to the house of, like, paying stuff, but probably, like, to my bank account. Because that's what my mom really wants. Is for me to have more... Is for me to save and have money in the future. And I probably will pay the household. Although I'm probably not going to make enough money to do that. Not for a couple of years at least. But yeah. And unless Nintendo has something to say about it. You know, I don't really get Nintendo. I think Nintendo is a really, really makes good games. It really is actually known for quality games. Although I don't really like some of the games. I can see the quality in them. But the problem is, they just don't really make, they aren't really good for getting third-party support for their consoles. They're good for making unique consoles, of course. They're only really gimmick consoles, what I mean to say. Sometimes they could work, but that's because of, well, let's just say, third-party supporters. And sometimes, because of actual design. But most of the time, they won't. They're not really that great. And they cost as much as they are. Nintendo actually makes a profit off the console. I know that's like really weird why I'm like complaining about that. But unless you get the facts that most don't. Well, actually they don't. The other two, like 360 and PlayStation 3 don't. They actually take a loss with the consoles. They actually make money during the games. Which is good because they can add extra features to the console, and also for lastability, like if you look at the Wii and the Wii U, they don't really have really great graphics. And people say that graphics aren't everything. They kind of are in a console. They actually really are. Sorry, I get in a game they wouldn't be like the most amazing thing. Although I've seen the definition of graphics is different, like 2D games like really have amazing graphics, even though they're just 2D and versus 3D. But it's a console, which is one of the unique features is it has, which is one of the features is its graphics, and it has always, that should really be one of the main features. Like, I kind of get that the game, although they're both equal. Like, I don't think most people would be playing, like, Minecraft if it looked like shit. Minecraft doesn't look amazing, but it looks really good. But I don't think people would be playing it if it just looked like shit. That much. Like, you still gotta have craft. But still. It's like, it's a console. Its whole design is to get you a unique experience with updated graphics, updated everything, so that way it can sell you. And I don't really think the Wii U is, not graphics, but I don't think the Wii U is, like, really gimmick, which it really is. It's really that amazing. And unfortunately, Nintendo has a problem with censoring stuff, which is really bad. And actually has got it a lot of just kind of a kitty game, because that's what it tried to make. It tried to make the Wii into a kitty game. Well, you know, kitties play the M-rated games. And unfortunately, that's not what you have. I played games when I was a kid. M-rated games, so I would never say that that's a problem for kids to play M-rated games. And I hate people who try and say it is. It's like, why? And then they just stare at you going, I mean, they don't really say anything against it. They just, I don't know, it's like stupidity. It's like, there's been proof that it does not affect you any negative way. The only thing it does is when you're playing a game and then you lose, you get a little bit mad for 5 seconds. Then you get over it. That's about the same effect that you have when you watch a video, when you watch a movie and you're disappointed by the movie. When you play sports, like hockey, and you're disappointed about your game that you played or that your team lost. So it's basically, That's like not a negative. That's just part of life. Of course, playing it way too much and like not really like doing anything with that can like destroy your life. But yeah. But yeah, I really hate how people say that it's so bad to play video games. Like, for kids to play video games. Like, no, it's not. The kids have been playing video games forever. What the fuck? Wow. I was thinking that it would, like, wait. That's why. Although I do like that it really just started now. But yeah, unfortunately, but the thing about censoring is it's got rid of the fans who really love video games. Like people say, like the hardcore gamers. What it really means is people who actually buy more than one or two games a year. I don't really get the casual or hard. Casual is still people who play at least one or two games, and even they would not. I don't think M-rated has to do with any casual or hardcore aspects of the game. I think it has to do with the storyline, blood, violence, and just a overall unique style that it wants to give to the player. But I think the problem with the... So they got rid of, like, a lot of games that... And then they started, like, getting rid back the M-rated games at the end, because you want to know why? They were losing money. Yeah. The thing is, the Wii sold good, But there, it's a dust collector. Unfortunately, Nintendo is getting badder and badder at making consoles. Like, not consoles, but getting third-party support, getting advertisement, and not getting rid of Let's Players. But it's not getting bad remark. I think, you know, there's some part of, like, they follow the trend, like with the PS3 and everybody, they follow a certain trend, like if something's new. But Nintendo has the fact that it tries something new because it's the hottest thing, and they don't really seem to get hottest thing will go. Like, they try it, like, I did buy the Wii games, but the third party support is weighing because, well, the console was really hard to control for, and, you know, it was so graphically lower than every other game. It's like every game graphically worse. I mean, it's like that's your main part of a video game, of your console. Like, people really want to use them. Developers who want to showcase their games really want to use the graphical input of the games of the Wii. And the Wii U is probably not the worst, but it's definitely not going to be as, not even close to good than the Wii, than the PS1 or the 360 PS4. Don't really get the negative problems with, like, people whining about the Xbox One. I think people are complaining about the Xbox One or just become kind of complainers that they complain every console. Like, Nintendo the reason that I'm complaining about the Nintendo, I'm not complaining like random things or just like minor things. They have no third-party support, and the supporters even say, well, why don't they just create their own games on this console? Well, because that would be stupid. I mean, why don't they just only do their own games? Well, that'd be stupid, and that would lose, it wouldn't lose money, but it wouldn't make money as much, and you might as well just quit the consoles. Like, just, you know. So, you know what? I've had enough of consoles. I don't think Nintendo should do that, but they really should get their act together. I think once they say, okay, we're not going to do the Let's Players thing, and we're going to try and market the games, and we're going to try and get gamers and try and get developers by offering things, or like, just showing what the Wii U can do, or whatever it's called. Yeah, it's called the Wii U. I think that would be great. But the Let's Players are really important part, because they're in your marketing. Especially since the marketing isn't really that good, but it also is hindered by the fact that it costs a lot to market. Let's Players take that market in. People say, like, it's, you know, they should have the right to not get the money. They should have the right to get the money because, you know, it's their game and everything. And I don't know about that. I do know it's their game, but I don't know if it's actually, they can technically say it's copyrighted material, because I think it's when you take something and make it your own, like a parody, like really of a parody kind of like thing. Like, that's why you can't sue somebody for like releasing a parody. Can't sue somebody, it's a parody. Like anything, or it's making your own as something. So I really think they don't have right to like do that, but I don't really know. But I don't think even you guys know. People are trying to explain. But that's why I say, like, I'm not really sure that they even have the right. But even so, it's like, it's just stupid. Because it's not like it deters people from playing the game. In fact, that's why I say it's marketing it. People want to play it. It's not like it's a movie. Even movie reviews make people want to watch the movie. Even spoiler movie reviews make people want to buy the movie or watch it. So it's not really... So I don't think it's really bad for Let's Player. And you know what? You could say it's their right. And you could actually look it up and actually be right. But you know what? That still doesn't mean... Ah, Matt Smith. The Doctor. Doctor Who. I love Doctor Who. But I still don't think it's right. And I blame YouTube for that. Not because of them, like... Like, I get why they wouldn't really want to, like, challenge Nintendo for that. But I actually think they actually asked them. Because they asked the creator of Minecraft to do it. And he said, fuck you. Well, of course. He made millions and millions of dollars because of less players. Yeah, in fact, the reason that I'm playing Minecraft now, and I'm playing all this mod... Quakecraft is because of the Less Players. Because I wouldn't have found this map out if it wasn't for Less Players. And also, it's because of Less Players that just buy the game in the first place, play it. And because of that, they make mods. People, it's like an endless circle of money making for Mojang or whatever his name is. To make money because of Let's Players. And even like linear games, I still think that, you know, it's about personality and everything. And it's about your own. Like people, of course some people want to play it, watch the game for them. And you know what? I have watched a movie of a game because of it. Because, you know, I just wanted to watch the movie. But, guess what? I also bought the game. And I bought the game after I watched the movie. Because I just... Like, with Halo... I just really wanted to get the full story without getting the, like, waiting time. But I still have the game, Halo. Like, I did not buy it. Well, and then that's also me. I, like, tend to support the company. Of course, I don't want to go broke because of it, but, you know... I don't think I'll ever go broke because of it, because, you know, I'm going to be smart. I'm going to have a budget of what I can spend, and I'm going to have a budget of what I can save. But I just tend to support the companies, and, you know, everything, because, you know... I want to play the next game, and I want to watch the next movie or the next TV show, and you know, it's really just easy to support the guys, well for me anyway. But it's actually easy for a lot of people now because of, if you're not really that like inclined to make, like have money, well there are ways, like if you have an Xbox, which you probably do, or a PS3, you can get on Netflix for any PC even, but you can get an anime service for anime. Anime TV show, not an anime TV show, but an anime channel that's on the web. Uncut, really great, because I hate censorship. Don't really get it. It's like protecting the children, even though there's no such really thing about that. Does not make sense because, you know, children, that's what you're supposed to learn. You're supposed to learn that the world. And just blocking them from it because they said, oh, they're innocent. Well, you know what? I was innocent at watching M-rated video. I was playing M-rated games and 18 plus movies. I think it's Canada. I don't really... I know the R-rated is American. That's for... I know we have R-rated, but I think that's a different thing. I think we have... But, R-rated is, like, slasher films and everything. And, like, just blood and guts and everything. But that's not really bad. Because, you know, like, you're not... I don't think it's, like, you're... it's, like, a teaching material. But I don't... You're not supposed to block the kid from it. Because you're preparing them for the next line in their lives. You're preparing them. You can't... A lot of parents like to block because they think, oh, well, I'll teach them when it happens. Yeah. Because, you know, you can really predict. I mean, an 8-year-old is doing drugs. There are 8-year-olds doing heavy cocaine and everything. And yet, and people have like a thing of, you know, well, I'll teach kids about drugs when they're 16. Most kids go under 14, but you want to prepare them beforehand, because you don't want to teach them even while they're influenced, because, you know, you want to teach them before that. You want to teach them, and, you know, it's also good to teach them about the goods, about the good effects of drugs, because so that way they don't, because, you know, it's like, if you teach them about the bad side and everything, then people will kind of, you get a one-sided view. And then there's somebody who's saying, well, yeah, they're bad, but here are the good side effects, and actually pointing a two-sided review show, and actually, you know, actually makes sense. And, you know, you go, well, that's two-sided. And, you know, he actually said that it's bad, but he also said positive. And, you know, you got the guy who's, like, master manipulator and everything. So you really want to prepare them for what? You also want to show them that sometimes crime pays. And, you know, sometimes gangster. Because you don't really want them to, like, get persuaded by that. Because, you know, you have blocked them from the fact that they get paid. And then somebody says, well, I get lots of money. And then they go, it's really amazing. Nobody told me about that. I mean, if you teach kids, kids are actually smart. People don't want to do the bad thing. But, you know, I've actually learned this, but kids, it's best to learn. It's best to teach kids about things before that. And teach does not mean do, which I think a lot of people like tend to mistake. Like, watching a movie is not doing what they're doing, it's teaching them. And you're supposed to teach them about how life sucks, and, you know, about negative stuff beforehand, because people are easily manipulators. People are, evil people manipulate people. And if you block them from the fact that there is good stuff for doing drugs and everything, and doing, well, I don't think there are really good qualities. But there are, for other things, like stealing and everything, then you really just block them from the, then you really just are saying, well, you know, I really want my kid to do that. That's what you're saying. You really want your kid to actually do drugs and everything, because they're just going to say, hey, you know, it's actually, yeah, it's bad, but this is also good. Why didn't he teach you about that? And, you know, it's, yeah, to a kid who's learned about the good and bad, he's really like, Still, I still think it's bad. Yeah, it's gonna be not tempting, but to a kid who's just really learned, who's really been only taught that there are black and white, it's gonna actually open their eyes and it's like, there's not black and white. The world is black, white, gray, blue, green, yellow, whatever color you put into it. Whatever color. And you also want to the video games, like, people say it's bad. But then it's kind of like, well, guess who created Minecraft? Guess who created... And they played M-rated games probably as a kid. Guess who created slasher films? People who watched M-rated movies. 18A movies as a kid. And you know, there isn't anything bad. And yet they're making millions and billions of dollars, and yet you want to block them from that? I don't know about you. And some people say, well, they change. Well, is really change bad? Because you don't really want... I don't really want to be whining every time something happens in my life. Like a kid does. Because, you know, being a spoiled brat and everything, I don't really want that. Do I know? I want to grow. You gotta learn. You gotta grow. And people say, well, it's like, that's bad. What's like, really? Or is it bad being a child? Is it bad having a child's mind while being an adult? And not just the fact that you like kids, toys and everything, and you're like, magic, you know, whatever thing people try and say, but like the negative. Like, the inability, like... to